At the end of the topic, you will be able to analyze the causes that led to the launch of the civil disobedient movement, explain the roundtable conferences, discuss the Gandhi-Irwin Pact, describe the Communal Award and Pune Pact. Gandhiji requested all Indians to boycott the rules and laws laid down by the British government. This movement meant a refusal to obey the demands and commands of the government.
Civil Disobedience Movement. Mahatma Gandhi started the Civil Disobedience Movement on 12th March 1930 with his Salt Satyagraha, also known as a Dandi March. Gandhiji, with other followers, set off on a long march on foot from Sabarmati to Dandi, a village on the Gujarat coast. He made salt, thus disobeying the salt laws. Several prominent leaders also undertook the salt satyagraha. Rajagopalachari undertook a similar salt march in Vedaranyam in Tamil Nadu. Around 90,000 satyagrahis were arrested by the British.
The launch of the civil disobedience movement was triggered off by Salt Satyagraha, which was a campaign of non-violent protest against the British salt monopoly in colonial India. The protest began with the Dandi March on 12th March 1930 and was led by Gandhiji from his base, the Sabarmati Ashram at Ahmedabad. He walked bare feet with a large number of satyagrahis for 24 days and covered 390 kilometers. His main aim was to break the salt law of the government. He broke the salt law on April 6, 1930 at the Dandi village on the western coast of India in Gujarat by preparing salt after boiling the seawater. This sparked large-scale acts of civil disobedience against the British Raj's salt laws by millions of Indians. C. Rajagopalachari broke the salt laws at Vedaranyam. First Roundtable Conference. The British government decided to host the first roundtable conference in November 1930 in London to revise the proposals of the Simon Commission. The Congress was already boycotting all government-arranged meetings and conferences, and therefore it boycotted this roundtable conference too. However, this conference was attended by the members of the Muslim League, the Indian Kings of Princely States, and the representatives of the Hindu Mahasabha. No decisions were made in this conference, as the British too had realized that without the participation of the Congress, they could not make any constitutional changes in India. Gandhi-Irwin Pact. Gandhi-Irwin Pact refers to a political agreement signed by Gandhiji and Viceroy Irwin on 5th March 1931, before the Second Roundtable Conference. Viceroy Irwin was sent by the British government to persuade the Congress to participate in the Second Roundtable Conference. Some of the conditions of this pact were discontinuation of the civil disobedience movement by the Congress, participation of the Congress in the Second Roundtable Conference, withdrawal of all ordinances and prosecutions against the Indians by the British, release of all political prisoners except those who were guilty of violence. Second Roundtable Conference. Sardar Vallabhai Patel approved the idea of Gandhi-Irwin Pact, and Gandhiji was chosen to attend the Second Roundtable Conference. This conference was held on September 7, 1931. In this conference, Gandhiji could not reach an agreement with the Muslims on Muslim representation and safeguards. At the end of this conference, Ramsay MacDonald decided to set up the Communal Award for Minority Representation in India.
The Communal Awards. The then British Prime Minister, Ramsay MacDonald, came up with the idea of communal awards to solve the problem of communal issues in India. According to this award, the right to separate electorates was given to the Muslims and other minority communities including the untouchables in India. However, the Hindus refused to accept this award as it divided the communities from one another, and they decided to campaign against this. The Muslims too were not totally convinced, but they accepted the award. Gandhiji was not in favor of separate electorates for different communities, and he called for a joint electorate. This electorate gave an increased representation to the depressed classes from 71 to 147.
Third Roundtable Conference. The third and the final Roundtable Conference was held on November 17, 1932. Most of the important political leaders from India did not attend the session. The Labour Party from England and the Congress refused to attend the same. In 1934, the Congress passed a resolution demanding a constituent assembly elected by the citizens of India on the basis of universal adult franchise. This assembly would give the Indians a choice to decide under what type of government they would like to live.
In this topic you have learnt, Gandhi made salt at Dandi, a village in coastal Gujarat, defying the salt law on 12th March 1930. C. Rajagopalachari broke the salt laws at Vedaranyam. Viceroy Irwin was sent by the British government to persuade the Congress to attend the second roundtable conference. Gandhi-Irwin Pact was signed by Gandhi and Viceroy Irwin on 5th March 1931. The then British Prime Minister, Ramsay MacDonald, came up with the idea of communal awards. The third roundtable conference was held in 1932 in London.